Ooh, no discoloration in the hamstring this morning, so it's not a tear. So thank heavens, that's some good news. I can walk with no impediment, and I'm able to do almost everything physically with no impediments. However, I can't bend forward without feeling a slight pull. So just gonna take a couple weeks, no underhands for a while, and nothing that aggravates it. Let it heal, use ice, heat, and stem as needed over the course of the next 2 to 3 weeks, but I'm not gonna cut any underhands to let it heal, so, yeah. February 27th, I'm gonna have to work again today. Yeah, the new normal. I'm actually becoming quite efficient at teleworking and chopping and sawing at the same time and lifting. Anyway, hamstring is doing well. It is a little bit sore, but I've been doing the prehab and the ice and the heat, and it's just a minor strain. There was no discoloration. So just gotta be nursing and not cut underhands. This is not my first rodeo. I have fought this issue at length all spring during 2018 when I was preparing for the Champions Trophy in Marseille, France. And so I was unable to cut an underhand effectively because of this hamstring. I was basically chopping stiff-legged and on one leg, which is impossible because you dog-leg every cut. Anyway, I had some fun today. Fun fact, was driving through South Hills and I saw where one of my neighbors had a bunch of poplar trees cut down behind his house. And I just picked up a bunch of training wood that I gotta somehow get over the course of the next couple weeks. So that's cool. I haven't cut softwood in forever. The trees look nice and straight and probably get about 30 or 40 blocks out of the two trees. So yeah, that's pretty good. Time to get started with a little bit of event work. Over the course of the past 12 weeks, I've concentrated primarily on underhand. And as a result of that, I feel pretty comfortable with it. However, the injury with my hamstring is going to prevent me from doing any of that training for probably 2 to 3 weeks at least. And so now I'll get back to doing the stuff that I enjoy, which is single and standing block. So, and springboard now for some unknown reason. Had to put another log up. There was some suspect crap in that first one, and so this is about a 17 inch log, and I don't know how many cuts I've done thus far. 3, 4, 5, shit, I don't know. I'm just that sort of special. My dumbass turned the 16-inch tulip. Now I get the dry side. Thank you. shit that I chop in Muscle Hauler. This baby, look at that. That's right in the down hit in the front. So I'm going to try and open a narrow as scarf as I can on this little bugger, and then just get swings in on this just to work on, I don't know. I cut standard blocks pretty naturally, so this is just going to be just a warm-up. Next, we got ourselves a full 38-inch black oak. Piss on, I'm gonna race this thing. What the hell? If, as long as it's clear and doesn't, and then not snowball pop up, I'm gonna try and cut it in 15 and 15. I think that's a fair cut on it.
Big limb.
His friendlies in there.
Little bastard right there.
Jesus, Murphy. Train on bad wood, but I do have different degrees of training axes that are better than the super thick stuff that I cut knots with, and I just don't want to bust up one of my better training axes, which is more than likely 16-17 degrees with a nice thick woolly butt edge on it, but it won't take those knots straight up. I mean, it'd crinkle it or bend it or break it or whatever, so there's just not worth the risk of busting a good axe or a decent training axe. I've got a 42-inch sycamore hardwood. I'm going to use my best training axe. I believe it's clear. I hope. If it's not, I'm stopping. Good Lord. I have no idea what to expect in this, but 15 and 15 would be friggin' perfect, but more realistically, it's probably going to be 17 and 17 or maybe more. Got that one pretty nice. Pleased with that. All right, I got a foot black oak. It's shit. So I'm gonna use my uber thick tool, which is freaking 20 degrees. And so basically I'm pounding this off with a sharpened baseball bat. Got my sharpened baseball bat, or cricket bat, whatever the hell you want to call it. And I'm going to cut a 11-inch black oak. So, yikes. Here we go. Dumbass got pissed off at that last cut, so I'm making another one because I hate ending a single session on a bad cut. And I like what I'm seeing. The hamstring doesn't impact this at all, so this will be my eighth cut, which is kind of stupid. Against what my body's telling me to do, I'm gonna go back up this freaking tree and whittle them up for a little bit.